Hey everybody, I hope you're doing well today. Okay, today, let's do some more ear training. So this will be ear training two, okay? So we left off with Mary Had a Little Lamb, okay? And I had showed you a couple of different ways to do that. So what I just did was I went ahead with that second version that was slides on the third string. And I just have went one more step beyond and added some things to it, okay? So this is not necessarily the way you need to do every one of them, of course, but this is just an example of something you can do, okay? When you find a way of doing the song that you like, experiment with it. Okay, so let me just play a little bit of it for you and then we'll talk about it. So what I've done here is I've used the same little thing. Okay, but I have embellished it a little bit with some double thumb. I've added some strumming to it. I've also added a chord to it. Okay, I've added the D7 chord to it. So, what I want you to get from this one is to take what you've done over here, the work you've done over here, now transfer it over here and do some work over here, okay? So, as I said before on the last one, things to add are your strums, your basic claw hammer strokes. Add those in. Add some double thumbing. You can try drop thumbing. Add in slides. You're just doing your standard embellishments that I've taught you all along. Just your standard embellishments. Play around with it. May not have noticed that I played that a little bit differently. And the reason I played it a little bit differently is because my mind is open to this, okay? I don't really know how to explain this to you, but I don't want you to get locked in anywhere, okay? If you find something over here and you pick out the notes that you like and experiment around with it, as long as your mind is open to other things, you'll find other things. Okay, so that right there. I used a couple more strums there. That time, I did some double thumbing there. See which one you like better. That was one. That was the other one. Just listen to what you're doing. Be open, okay? Be open to change. We're not doing a tab sheet. We're not locked in anywhere here. And that's the beauty of learning and playing by ear. Now, obviously, this is just one little example of one song. I kind of struggled a little bit with how to teach you how to train your ear. But I think that this will work for you. You know, this is just what I've used over the years. And I know that it works. You have to be free up here. You have to not get locked into anything. And when I say get locked into anything, I mean that you won't budge off of it. Yes, you want to find your notes, yes. But it's more than that, okay? Because remember what I said last time, these notes are all over the place, okay? The same ones. So when you're doing your strums and everything, you want it to sound good. So adding in chords sounds nice. And experimenting with different parts of the song all over the place is what you need to do. So after you take that song and you just find those notes, I want you to build upon that, okay? All we're doing is building upon our skills, and that's the way I teach you, okay? You know, you start out with your basic claw hammer stroke, you add in some chords, then you start doing some single note stuff. Everything is just building one on top of the other. So with the ear training, it's the same thing. We break it down to the simplest thing we can, which is just finding those beginning notes that we like. Remember, there's other places to find those notes. But use the ones that sound pleasing to you. Add in those embellishments. Add in those strums. Those double thumbs, even some drop thumb if you can find, you know, a place for it. But the main thing here for ear training too is just open your mind, okay? Don't be locked in anywhere. Even if you might come up, you know, you might be, and I find this a lot, okay? This is a good little tidbit right here. Bing. When I'm looking for notes and trying to pick out a song, I may get halfway through the song and find a really nice fitting note somewhere. I may find a really nice fitting note somewhere, but it doesn't fit with my first half of the song. Okay, don't be locked in. If I really like where that little lick came from or the way that sounded, I can ditch the first part. I'm okay with that, all right? Don't be locked into it. Then work around that part, okay, that you found somewhere else. So don't be afraid to change things that you've already sort of established. Don't be locked in, okay? That's very important with ear training. And another thing, you know, there's different ways to go about ear training, okay? We can listen to a recording, like I was talking about earlier. We can listen to a recording of somebody playing a song, and we can pick out those exact notes, note for note, if we want to, okay? But we don't have to. We're not locked into that, okay? I want you to really understand about getting locked in on something. If your desire is to pick it out note for note, then by all means, do so. And yes, there is a place for that, and it's very important to do that if that's what you're wanting to do there. But if you're just wanting to make the song your own or have it in another key so that you can sing with it or play it with another instrument, whatever your goal is here, okay, don't be afraid to go after it, because like I just showed you on Mary Had a Little Lamb, this is really a rule for every song in the world, okay? Yes, the song was originally written using these specific notes, and you can go in search of those and find them, absolutely, and there's nothing wrong with that. But you can also play the song using different notes, okay, which will put it in a different key, and don't be afraid to do that, okay? I try to play songs uniquely and differently. Sometimes I'll stick right with it, but other times I'll go off on my own. And I have found that really the songs where I go off on my own and come up with my own rhythm for it, my own you know, path, so to speak, for it, those songs are my most popular. Those are the ones that people seem to like the most. So, I think that's important. And I don't, you know, that's my favorite thing to look for out there, too. Me, personally, I like it, too. So, I just don't want you to get locked in. So, that's the main goal of number two here. Don't get locked into anything, all right? Okay, I hope you learned something out of that. I hope you took something from that. And I hope you go and run with it, all right? And please, feel free to share with me what you're doing, you know? Comment down below. Say, hey, I've rocked Mary Had a Little Lamb in like 10 different ways. Or I went and did this or that or the other or whatever, you know? Those are little victories, and I'd love it if you'd share them with me, you know? Hit like, hit subscribe, and comment. Let me hear it. And if you thought this was terrible, hey, let me hear it too. My ears are open, so I'm here for it all. I'll take it. But anyway, it's a beautiful day here. I've got things and projects going on that I need to get to. So I hope you have a glorious day. And I just want you to always remember that Jesus loves you. Bye-bye.